Hi there. I'm here today to demonstrate the use of the digital player device supplied to you as part of a federal initiative in collaboration with ALIA and the State Library of Queensland. I've got my player plugged into the wall, but if you leave it plugged in, they will charge. Quite often it can take up to 8 hours, but the charge does last for some time. All the buttons on the Daisy player are all different shapes and different textures in different locations to make it easier for you to find them if you have a vision impairment. The on-off button is this round button here, and it lights up when it's been turned on, and it's also slightly recessed into the model to make it easier for you not to bump it or to accidentally turn it off.
Please wait.
If you've recently charged your machine or if you've just put new batteries into it, it can take up to 20 seconds. So make sure you hold that button down until the machine gives an indication that it is actually ready to go.
There is no disc inserted.
If there's nothing in it, it tells you. If there is a disc already inside, this is where it would give you the track information. We just happen to have a disc here ready to go. The slot to put the disc inside is at the front, and you just push it in until the machine grabs it and sucks it inside. There isn't a tray or anything that you need to leave the disc on. This chime music is the thinking music. When you hear that, you know something is going on.
Disc, Daisy title.
This is the Hobbies and Recreation Daisy magazine compilation for November 2009, containing two magazines produced in October and November 2009.
I'm just going to pause that information.
This is the Hobbies and Recreation.
That's better. I'm pausing using the Play Stop button. If you pause a disc using the Play Stop button and you finish listening to it and come back to it at a later time, it remembers where you're up to. So that's a bookmarking mechanism there. If you just stopped your disc using the Off button, then it doesn't remember and will replay it back from the start. So once you have finished listening to whatever chapter or whatever article you were reading, hit your stop button to pause it at the right spot, and then depress the on-off button.
Power off.
And it will tell you that it is now off. Alright, we now have a disc that is paused inside the Daisy player, and I just wanted to demonstrate the sleep function. If you wish to listen to your player to go to sleep, just like reading a book to fall asleep, this button is the sleep timer button. Continuous pressing.
Sleep timer, 15 minutes set, 30 minutes set.
Increases the period of time up to an hour.
45 minutes set, 1 hour set.
If you need more than 1 hour to fall asleep, you're not tired. Pressing it one more time.
Sleep timer, the time remaining is 59 minutes.
Gives you a countdown of where you're up to. And if you wish to turn it off, you keep pressing the button until it tells you that the timer is off.
Sleep timer, the time, 1 hour, off.
Once it's off and you hear the chime, then it will play continuously until you turn it off or it hits the end of the story. Now, to eject a disc is this square purple button down here. Just push it once, we pop the disc out. Now, if for any reason you ever insert a disc upside down, which is easy to do,
there is no disc inserted.
The machine will analyse that and give you a message indicating that the disc is either damaged or upside down, and that's when you know you can flick it over after you've ejected it.
Damaged or improper disc, eject.
And it comes straight back out again. Now, the slot...
There is no disc inserted.
Let me pause you before you keep talking.
There is no disc inserted. Power off.
Power off. The slot at the front is where the CD goes. If you have a Daisy format CD or an MP3 on CD or any other CD format, over this side is where your USB goes in. USBs are also compatible with this player, so you can put any format on this, a PDF or a doc or an MP3, and just insert it in and the machine will register that you have this. If you have any information on an SD card, the SD card slot is right here. And finally, there's a slot for headphones. If you're using this in a communal area, in the library, or you just don't wish to bother your partner with a story. Now we're going to be talking about the title keys. Title keys are different to fast forward keys. Imagine a book or a magazine with several chapters or several articles, the title keys, which are these arrows here, are the ones that shuffle through each chapter or each title or each document on your media and give you the heading of what you can listen to. I'll just start the player and I'll show you what I mean.
Beginning of title.
So.
This is one.
Chapter one.
This is the Hobbies and Recreation Daisy magazine compilation for November 2009, containing two magazines produced in October and November 2009.
So I want to jump ahead to the next title.
This is Silicon Chip for November 2009, narrated by Lee J.
And again.
Three. This is Wheels for October 2009, narrated by Jonathan Ramsden.
And as soon as
this is Wheels for October.
That's the chime. Chime means that it's paused. As soon as you get the heading of the title, then the article or the chapter launches automatically. So you can flick through until you find the one that you're interested in and then play from there. In comparison to the title buttons, which move you through chapters, the rewind button and the fast forward button work just like in an ordinary recorder, but they work in two separate ways. You can hold one down to only move a little bit through the text, or you can continuously press it and it will jump you through the story in increments of time. I'll show you what I mean. So if you only wanted to fast forward a little bit, you hear the chipmunk talk, and then you're a few lines through the book. So you wait until you hear that chipmunk, and you fast forward it through. This doesn't damage the disk and it doesn't do any damage to the machine. But if you wanted to go a bit further through the book, hold the button down for longer, pass the chipmunk talk. See? And you can keep holding it down.
10 minutes.
You can go 10 minutes into a story.
Minutes.
Ooh, and play.
Family of front drive.
And then it takes you where you need to go. The rewind button operates the same way. Hold it down for a little bit. You get the chipmunk noise and it's rewinding, but only slowly. Hold it down continuously and it starts rewinding in increments.
-1 minute.
And the play button starts you at -1 minute from where you previously were. Now we're going to be talking about the volume controls. The volume controls make the sound louder or softer, depending to the situation that you're in or your comfortable level of listening. I'll start the recorder again with the play button.
Doesn't mean it won't benefit from
being... To make the voice louder,
tech.
I just keep pushing.
Well, it'll be built on a conventional steel platform.
You and each time I press it, the sound gets louder. If you wish to hold it down, you can do that too.
The engine lineup will be strictly...
And it will keep beeping until you actually get the volume that you're after. Now, as well as volume control, there's also tone control. Depending on how you're comfortable at hearing, you might prefer lower tone voices or higher tone voices might be more effective to you. So you can lower the tone by pushing this button here. I'll just make that a bit louder so you can hear the difference. Okay. So this is lowering the tone. You know, the voice is getting lower. And this is raising the pitch of the tone. He went away. He went back.
Mercedes-Benz SLS exclusive. Isn't it?
There we go.
Gull wings open wide. We all
so
know.
Volume is the larger button.
We know
on
just
the right hand side,
these
and pitch
SLS
is on the left.
After belting
the last thing we're going to show you today is the key describer mode. Now, if you forget what you've learned here today and you remember this part, this will help you understand what all the buttons are used for. Holding down, rewind and fast forward together turns the machine into key describer mode.
Key describer on.
Key describer means that every time you push a button,
sleep timer key,
it will give you a description of the button that you are pressing. So if you forget what a button does, or if you need to know which button does what, key describer mode will tell you.
Eject key. Next title key, press together with the previous title key to change media. Fast forward. Press and hold together with a rewind key to turn key describer on or off. Volume up key to reset the volume to the normal level. Press the volume up and volume down keys together. Tone up key to reset the tone to the normal level. Press the tone up and tone down keys together.
So if you forget what you learned today, that's the easy way to remember. To turn this off, you hold the two buttons down again.
Key describer off.
Until the machine tells you that the key describer is off. Thank you for watching and listening to our presentation today. Remember, if you need more help or assistance with your digital player, with the players you will find a Getting Started Guide, the Advanced Users Guide, and a laminated cheat sheet talking about all the buttons that we have discussed today. If you want more information, at the end of this presentation, we'll give you the address of the website on the State Library webpage where you can go for more information and to get more copies of these handouts if you wish to print them out. Thank you again. Talk to you soon.